everyone, my name is Haley and welcome back or welcome to my channel. So for today's video, it is obviously going to be a vlog, and I haven't done a Barnes & Noble vlog or even gone to a Barnes & Noble in a while, so I thought that would be fun to do today. It's a pretty nice day out, so I don't want to be inside all day, and I haven't really had a weekend to myself in a while, so this will be really nice, like taking myself on a date type of thing. I don't know if I'm going to buy anything, but I just want to see what's out there, and I just love going to bookstores, so that's what we're going to do. I also, if I'm feeling up for it, want to try and find that viral pink ghost blanket that's at Home Goods, I think, but I'm gonna check Marshall's and like TJ Maxx if I'm in the mood. So that's the plan for today.
Okay, fit check, Converse, tank top,
these two necklaces. So that is what we're working with. I am going to fill up my water, use the bathroom, and then we will be on our way. Take about 15-20 minutes to get there. I'm not looking for anything specifically, but I want to see like what new releases are out, because now that I don't work at a bookstore, I don't know what's new. So I want to go and scour and see what I can find. Busy because I'm still not super comfortable or used to vlogging in public. If it is really busy, I will probably just do a voiceover but still like film the books, just like not talk. But let's hope that's not the case. I really loved this book, but I don't know if I'm in the mood for stories. I really loved The Hacienda, but I might wait for this to come out in paperback just because hardcovers can be so expensive. $28. Yeah, I might have to wait or read it from the library and then buy the paperback when it comes out, but I'm really actually excited to read this. I've heard good things about this. I never read her books, but I always hear good things also. This, I'm obsessed with this cover, and I might buy it just because of that. I think it's so cute. And then this got a new cover, and I never owned the original. I've read it, but I don't own it, but I don't know if that's on my priority list. Definitely gonna pick this up. This is the same author of Love in the Time of Serial Killers. I read half of that and then I just never finished it, which I don't know why. Let's see what this is about. Okay, I don't really like second chance romance, so I won't be picking this up, but definitely this one. Again, obsessed with the cover. I definitely wanted to see what was new in the fantasy section, but again, they're all hardcovers, so I will be checking the paperback section, but this is a very good selection. I've never read any Christopher Paolini, but I really want to, and this sounds really good. But again, I might just get this from the library because it is hardcover. Also, this is a beautiful new cover of this book. I'd never finished this. I have a problem with never finishing things, but it's so pretty. I've never seen this book in stores, but I've heard really good things. But again, I don't know. And then also, Tracy Wolf with a new book. I never finished Crave. I read the first book, so I don't know how I'm going to like this. This sounded interesting, but one of my friends on Goodreads gave it a 1 star, and I trust her reviews, so I will not be picking this up. Okay, definitely need to pick this up. I love her work, and then it's buy one get one 50% off, so I might as well pick up the short stories as well. I have read this. I still haven't finished this. Loved this one, so I just have to finish the collection. This book sounds really interesting. It's about this woman who believes she's an alien, I guess. I really love Japanese fiction, but I don't know if this is gonna be on the top of my priority because I feel like I should read other Japanese fiction books I have first and then come back and grab this. So I think this will be on the back burner for now. Okay, I know I'm late to the game, but I'm finally picking up If We Were Villains. I've always wanted to read this, but I feel like this might be a series I read on my Kindle because I don't want to buy one in a series unless I like the whole thing. So I'm going to probably get this at the library, and maybe I'll do a reading vlog on the series if that is something you guys would like. I already have 3 different copies of Dune because of the covers, and I don't need more, but look at how stunning these are. It has obviously this beautiful cover, but also look at these sprayed edges. Are you kidding me? And then I guess this is the Barnes & Noble exclusive of that same hardcover. And look at this one. Oh my god, they're so beautiful. Eventually, oh my god, are you kidding me? And the inside cover. Okay, eventually I will buy this. Eventually. I really loved this first book. I read it on my Kindle. I don't own the physical copy though. And then the second one came out a few months ago. But I probably will read this on my Kindle as well. I find that I won't buy the physical copy of a series or a book really if I've already read it on my Kindle or started the series on my Kindle until like I have disposable income on so I can buy books I've already read, if that makes sense. When I go book shopping, it's mostly buying stuff that I haven't read before, so I don't want to just buy the second one. But this is your sign to read this series. It's so good. I'm really excited to read the second one. This is another one that I'll probably read on my Kindle just because I wasn't the biggest fan of These Violent Delights. So I know that this is an adult fantasy, so maybe I'll like it more, but I probably won't be buying the physical copy anytime soon unless I really like it. But like I said before, I'm not really buying physical copies of books I've already read unless it's like my favorite book. Also, I know everyone loves this. Probably get this on my Kindle as well, but this is definitely going on my TBR probably for like October just because it has the whimsical fantasy vibe. This has been on my TBR for so long, but I can't physically read a book this large because it's very intimidating, so I probably will read this on my Kindle and like not turn on the page count so I can just read and like not be concerned with how many pages I have, because that really helps me when I'm reading on my Kindle and reading long books is like not paying attention to the page count. So I really want to read this soon though, and then obviously this as well. Bag secured. I spent a little bit more than I wanted to, but I really haven't bought books in a while, and treating myself, you know. I also got myself a pink drink. I think I am going to go to Marshall's, TJ Maxx, whichever one is around here, and see if they have that pink blanket, and also just look around at their Halloween stuff because I know they have it out already. But then I might swing by my grandma's house and say hi, and then we will be going home and I will give you a haul of everything that I got. Unfortunately, the Marshall's run was a bust. I don't know if the blanket's only at Home Goods or what, but I always feel like Home Goods, TJ Maxx, and Marshall's carry the same items. They did have some really cute pink blankets, but not the ghost one that I was looking for. And I already have a Halloween blanket at home, so it's probably for the best.
depressed that I didn't find anything. They had some really cute candles also, like the lid had like a little glow-in-the-dark ghost on top, but I held back. I probably won't be doing any more like shopping for things until next month because I'm trying to save my money. So unless it's a necessity, I won't be buying it until September. And maybe there will be more Halloween stuff out by then. Now I am going to swing by my grandma's house, say hi, and then we will be going home and I can show you the books that I bought.
We are finally home and I am going to show you what I bought. I bought 5 books. You saw some of them in the vlog portion and some of them you didn't see, and I changed my mind. So let's just get into it. So the first book I picked up was actually 19 Claws and a Blackbird by Augustina Batsterica. I said I didn't want this when I first saw it because I wasn't really in the mood for short stories, but the more I thought about it, I don't really read short story collections and I feel like this could be a really good way to get out of a reading slump, and it's perfect for the fall vibes. I absolutely love Tender as the Flesh. After thinking about it for a little bit, I decided to pick it up. I will read the little thingy here for you. Also, the cover is stunning. It says, "This collection of 20 brutal, darkly funny short stories takes readers into their deepest fears and most disturbing fantasies. Through stories about violence and alienation, Batsterica's vision of the human experience emerges in complex, unexpected ways, often unsettling, sometimes thrilling, and always profound. In Roberto, a girl claims to have a rabbit between her legs, a woman's neighbor jumps to his death in a light, swift, and monstrous sound, and in Candy Pink, a woman fails to contend with a difficult breakup in 5 easy steps. I'm always in for whatever this author has. And then, I didn't show this one, but I actually got 2001 A Space Odyssey. A big reason was because I absolutely love this cover, but also there are just some classic, iconic books out there, and this is definitely one of them. And so I want to read books that are considered classics but aren't like written in the classic time period, but they're just really famous older books and iconic books. So I really want to read this. I never even watched the movie, so I'm really loving reading more science fiction. So this is short-ish, but let me read you the back of this in case you don't know what it's about. From the savannas of Africa at the dawn of mankind to the rings of Saturn as man ventures to the outer rim of our solar system, 2001 A Space Odyssey is a journey unlike any other. In this allegory of humanity's exploration of the universe and the universe's reaction to humanity, Arthur C. Clarke has created a novel that captures and expands on the vision of Stanley Kubrick's immortal film. It is a hallmark achievement in storytelling that follows the crew of the spacecraft Discovery as they embark on a mission to Saturn. Their vessel is controlled by HAL 9000, an artificially intelligent supercomputer capable of high-level cognitive functioning that rivals and perhaps threatens the human mind. This is hitting a little too close to home. Grappling with space exploration, the perils of technology, and the limits of human power, 2001 A Space Odyssey continues to be an enduring classic of cinematic scope. Very excited for this. Okay, next I did get With Love from Cold World. I'm obsessed with this cover. I will say it over and over and over again and you're gonna be like, shut up, but this is it. I don't have the other one because I probably should finish reading it before I buy it, but Lauren Fox is the bookkeeper for Cold World, a tourist destination that's always a winter wonderland despite being located in humid Orlando, Florida. Sure, it's ranked way below any of the trademarked amusement parks and maybe foot traffic could be better, but it's a fun place to work even if fun isn't exactly Lauren's middle name. Her co-worker, Asa Williamson, on the other hand, is all about finding ways to enliven his days at Cold World, whether that means organizing the Secret Santa or teasing Lauren. When the owner asks Lauren and Asa to propose something, anything really, to raise more revenue, their rivalry heats up as they compete to come up with the best idea. But the situation is more dire than they thought, and it might take these polar opposites working together to save the day. If Asa thought Lauren didn't know how to enjoy herself, he's surprised by how much he enjoys spending time with her. And if Lauren thought Asa wasn't serious about anything, she's surprised by how seriously he seems to take her. As Lauren and Asa work to rescue their beloved wintry spot, they realize the real attraction might be the heat generating between them. I haven't read a rom-com in a while. Like, that was a big genre that got me back into reading, but I haven't really picked one up in a long time, so I'm excited for this. Next book we have is If We Were Villains by ML Rio. I am late to the hype, like I mentioned earlier, but I'm feeling my dark academia era coming back, so I thought it'd be the perfect time to pick this up And every time I go to a bookstore, I want to buy this and I just never do. So I just decided today was the day. I'm sure you all know what this is about, but again, I'll read you the synopsis. Enter the players. There were seven of us then, seven bright young things with wide, precious futures ahead of us. Until that year, we saw no farther than the books in front of our faces. On the day Oliver Marks is released from jail, the man who put him there is waiting at the door. Detective Colborne wants to know the truth, and after 10 years, Oliver is finally ready to tell it. A decade ago, Oliver is one of seven young Shakespearean actors at Delacour Classical Conservatory, a place of keen ambition and fierce competition. In this secluded world of firelight and leather-bound books, Oliver and his friends play the same roles on stage and off. Hero, villain, tyrant, temptress, ingenue, extra. But in their fourth and final year, good-natured rivalries turn ugly, and on opening night, real violence invades the students' world of make-believe. In the morning, the fourth years find themselves facing their very own tragedy and their greatest acting challenge yet, convincing the police, each other, and themselves that they are innocent. I have really been loving mysteries lately, so I'm really excited to get into this. I'm also in the mood for some, like, really hateable characters, so I'm really excited for that. This last book has been on my radar for a while, and I want to build my science fiction collection, so I decided to pick it up today, and that is The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet by Becky Chambers. Also, just love this cover so much. I really want to get into a science fiction series, and so this is a series which convinced me even more to start it. When Rosemary Harper joins the crew of the Wayfarer, she isn't expecting much. The patched-up ship has seen better days, but it offers her everything she could possibly want. A spot to call home, a chance to explore the far-off corners of the galaxy and some distance from her past. And nothing could be further from what she's known than the crew of the Wayfarer. From Sissix, the exotic reptilian pilot, to Kizzy and Jinx, the chatty engineers who keep the ship running, to the noble Captain Ashby, life aboard is chaotic and crazy. Exactly what Rosemary wants. That is, until the crew is offered the job of a lifetime, tunneling wormholes through space to a distant planet. Sure, they'll earn enough money to live comfortably for years, but risking her life wasn't part of the job description. The journey through the galaxy is full of excitement, adventure, and mishaps for the Wayfarer team. And along the way, Rosemary comes to realize that a crew is a family, and that family isn't necessarily the worst thing in the universe, as long as you actually like them. So I've been looking for a space adventure, and this really seems like what that would be. And winner of the Hugo Award for Best Series. So if the synopsis didn't convince you, maybe that will. These are all of the books that I got today. I feel like there's a really good mix. I have short stories, which are technically horror. I have a romance. I have two science fiction and then one mystery. So I think we did really good today. Let me know if you've read any of those books, what you gave the rating, and if you want to recommend me any books, always feel free to comment down below. I'm always looking for new things to add to my TBR. But if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment, like, subscribe, all of that stuff. I hope you're all staying safe and healthy, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!